Have you ever wondered what the interrupting rating of a breaker is all about? Let's break into it. Okay, so every breaker is going to have two different amperage ratings, at least. The first is obvious. It's on the handle of these devices. This is a 20 amp breaker, so it says 20 on it. The second amperage is either on a sticker or it is stamped into the breaker itself. In this case, this one says interrupting rating 10,000 amps, max RMS symmetrical 120/240 volts AC. So why are there two different ratings? Well, the smaller number, the handle, can be thought of as a minimum, and the interrupting rating can be thought of as a maximum, kind of. So the ampere rating is the minimum value that, if exceeded, should cause this breaker to trip. So any values under this, you know, 18 amps, 16, 12, shouldn't make this thing trip. It should actually hold at 20 amps. But once we start to creep over that, there needs to be protection. So in an overloaded motor or overloaded a load, this thing needs to be able to trip if there's small amounts over this. So if we get to 120 to 130, 140 in that kind of a range, this breaker should trip. That is to simulate like a thermal overload. So basically this breaker is gonna get hot enough that the insides of the breaker will start to move a little bimetallic strip and it'll disengage the circuit, cause it to trip. The other thing that it needs to handle is larger values. So if there's a short circuit or some kind of ground fault, some kind of fault condition that's much larger where more current goes through, it needs to be able to trip as well. So there's a separate mechanism in here that's magnetic that does that. So if a large hit of current at 200% or more, which would be 40 amps in the case of this 20 amp breaker, if that happens, it disengages the circuit. But what if it's like way more current than just 200%? So instead of it being like 40 amps, what if it's like 1,000 amps that runs through? The breaker at a certain point is gonna break, right? I mean, you start throwing massive amounts of current, like it'll melt, it'll blow up, something's gonna happen. So there needs to be a maximum value for this breaker that it can handle before damage. And that's what an interrupting rating is. A lot of times you'll see it called an AIC rating, AIR rating, or IR rating. AIC just means amperage interrupting capacity. So I call it AIC, I just say that term a lot. But other people might say IR for interrupting rating or AIR for amperage interrupting rating. But it's all the same thing. It's just saying, what is this thing capable of handling at a maximum before it blows up? So this is where available fault current comes in. You'll hear this term available fault current from time to time. Residential services, we don't have to actually write the available fault current out on the service, but a lot of commercial and industrial occupancies or other places will actually have to do a calculation for how much available fault current is here. If something were to happen and this circuit shorts out, how bad can it get? How much current could flow through at this specific location? And available fault current is going to change depending on how far away we are from a transformer or what size conductors are run, how long the conductors are run, what kind of motor, what impedance. There's all kinds of things that go into figuring out what the available fault current is at a very specific point in the circuit. But that's what we need to know. If we're gonna install a breaker that has a maximum, what if the area in the circuit that we calculate exceeds this value? Well, they make breakers that are the same ampere rating on the handle, but that have higher interrupting ratings. So sometimes you'll see breakers that have 10 kA written on them, that's 10,000 amps. You'll have 22 kA, that's 22,000 amps, but they're the same handle size. So in this case, we've got a 3-pole 50, this is a 3-phase breaker, but both handles say 50 amps because the load that they're protecting is 50 amps. But the actual device itself needs to be able to protect more for some loads. So say this one specific load at this location, we did an available fault current calculation and we're getting like 12,500. Well, you can't stick a 10,000 in there. You'd have to go up the next size, and that's why they have 22,000. So still protects the load, just gives you a little bit more durability in the device itself because of available fault current that could change. Now, another reason that you might see people use these breakers that have the higher available fault current ratings is that if you notice, the lugs are actually bigger on the higher rated devices as well. Generally, with available fault current, the higher the wire size, the larger of the diameter of wire that you go, the higher the available fault current can be, because there's just less impedance in the circuit because you're providing more surface area for the current to travel through that wire. So some people will use these breakers simply because they have larger lugs and it's a little bit easier to work with, and that's okay too. But it's always a safe bet if you're doing that, if you're using breakers and you're paying attention to your available fault current at these points, still make sure, like regardless what your conductor size is, that the breaker or the device is that you're handling, especially if you're working in commercial or industrial. Now let's see what the code says about interrupting rating. Other than just the definition, let's go into 240 under overcurrent protection, because I know that it actually lists the interrupting rating of fuses and circuit breakers. That's the other thing, that fuses actually have to have an AIC rating as well. Let's see. For fuses, it says in part 6, cartridges, fuses, and fuse holders, in 240.60C marking, fuses shall be plainly marked either in printing on the fuse barrel or by label attachment to the barrel showing the following: amperage rating, voltage rating, and interrupting rating where other than 10,000 amperes. So other than 10,000 amperes, they actually need to have that on the breaker somehow. Current limiting where applicable, and the name or trademark of the manufacturer. It also says the interrupting rating shall be required to be marked on fuses used for, shall not be required to be marked on fuses used for supplementary protection. That's obvious. All right, then for circuit breakers, we go to part 7, and under marking, again, 240.83. Interrupting rating. Every circuit breaker having an interrupting rating other than 5,000 amperes shall have its interrupting rating shown on the circuit breaker. The interrupting rating shall not be required to be marked on circuit breakers used for supplementary protection. So again, supplementary protection is not the main breaker. Usually if you have a breaker and then you have like a piece of equipment that has its own kind of overload on the inside of it, it's got like a trip or reset thing inside of it, that would be considered supplementary. So oftentimes those are just made from the manufacturer and they don't follow under code. So speaking of interrupting ratings, thank you Big Electric Supply for sponsoring this episode. If you guys are interested, if you have some old legacy stuff like Pushmatic or Federal Pacific or Zinsco, Wadsworth, Challenger, they've got a whole bunch of different brand new replacement breakers that they sell. Link in the description below. There's actually a code as well. If you put the code in, you get a fat discount. So Big Electric Supply, thank you. I hope that helps clear some of this stuff up. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you have any other questions, comments. If you want anything else covered, any other weird terms or things that you don't understand, please leave some comments below. Make sure that you join the channel membership. I have a new channel membership tier. For those of you interested, there is the 1,000-volt tier now, and that gets you hooked up with my phone number. So you can text me whenever you want to, all your silly questions. Sometimes I will put little like texts out and let people know about like products that are coming out or things that I'm launching, courses I'm doing, anything like that. So hit up the 1,000-volt membership if you're interested in that. Make sure that you hit subscribe. That super helps me out for my numbers, for me doing this, being the YouTuber thing. So please subscribe if you watch these videos. Hit the like, hit the notification bell. Follow me on all the socials. Love you crazy people. I'll see you soon.
Descant music and video.